Former residents of the infamous Kinchela Boys Home near Kempsey on the New South Wales mid-north coast gathered on the weekend to lay the site's troubled past to rest. More than 500 boys lived in the home between 1924 and 1970. Many suffered serious physical and psychological abuse. NITV's Shayne Johnson spent the weekend with the brothers in Kempsey, and tomorrow night we'll bring you a special report on their journey.
The first thing that happened when I walked through the iron gate was to take off our shoes, and our IDs was taken away from us, and we was called a number, and my number was 24 for 11 years.
There was a feeling there that this is wrong, you know, even though I'm 8, you know, but here I am. Here's your bed. That's where you sleep, there's your clothes, that's what you wear. We'll put a number on it so we know who you are and what your clothes are.
Well, they tell me that the parents weren't alive.
Come on, family.
Ready? Are you ready, boys?
Yeah.
And where are we?
But this gate here is very symbolic to all us boys, you know. We're trying to represent we're free, you know, because we're inmates in this home. Not by choice, but incarcerated. In other words, we're prisoners. This is our boundary, couldn't jump it.
There was nowhere to go. They will bring you back. And when you got back, the staff, the manager, they would strip you down to your underpants and singlet, shave your hair, and you know the old Essen bags, they would make a sleeves, and you had that on for 2 weeks on bread and water inside where we used to turn our butter, for 2 weeks. On bread and water.